Tell me what you're out here advocating for or marching for or against.
Oh, I'm protesting the protesters because they don't understand gun control. They don't understand, if you actually read history, a lot of dictatorships or a lot of dictators use emotions and use gun control to get their agenda across.
Right.
So you're actually helping government basically hurt you.
Right, yeah. So you have all these kids advocating against, like, I guess, their own rights, you could say, right?
Exactly, yeah.
Right, to defend yourself.
Yeah.
When you saw, like, the government can't even protect those kids in Florida, the four county sheriffs were hiding.
Exactly,
right?
Exactly.
Okay, so you're advocating against, not their freedom of speech, but I guess you could say they're threats, you could say, right?
Big time.
Of government, right?
I mean, government's always a threat, though, because government's the reason that we have all these wars. Government always violates our rights. I mean, people understand government's not your friend.
Government's not your friend.
People don't even understand, even in the Constitution, police are not there to protect you.
Right.
There's laws, like I think Warren versus Columbia.
District of Columbia
talks about that cops don't have to protect you if they don't have the right to.
No obligation.
Exactly, no obligation. So it makes no sense to get rid of your guns and expect government to help you, even though government never helps you. They actually hurt you. They're actually the number one enemy.
Yes.
It's sad, but people need to literally get outside of the country. When you start going outside of the country, then you actually understand
what you're talking about. Bigger picture.
Exactly.
Yeah, the history that people kind of have here.
Yeah.
Kind of goes back to, like, the American Revolution, right?
Yes.
But they don't look outside the scope of which, like, social governments have always murdered their own people.
Yes.
Right?
You have Mao's.
Yeah, we have Mao's coming to China. You have
Stalin.
The Russians.
Yeah. Pol Pot. You have Nazi Germany. I mean, there's so many lists.
Right. So, Nazi Germany's a good one, right? Like, you know, they disarmed the Jews.
Yeah. Even America, we did it in the 40s with Japanese people.
We took their gun rights
and we put them in concentration camps.
They threw Asians in concentration camps,
but no one wants to talk about that.
Nobody talks about that.
At all.
Yeah. When a Democrat does, it's like, man, you know, it's not that racist, I guess. You know, this is for the country or something, right?
It makes no sense at all.
So you live around here in D.C. then?
Yeah.
So did you go to other protests and rallies?
Well, I went to the Women's March, and I was trying to – I'm more pro-life than pro-choice.
So. Right. So what in the pro-life position then be? To be anti-government?
Yes. Right. Well, if you really deep down, even in a scientific perspective, when scientists talk about bacteria and other planets, they say that's life. So that's the same thing as an egg or a fertilized egg.
Right.
It's the same thing as life. I used to be very pro-choice, and that's still kind of a hard issue with me because it's like you know, the pro-choice is more about freedom getting government out, but, like, what do you do when someone doesn't have rights? They can't, you know, vote, or not vote, but try to protest.
Right.
And when you're a fertilizer, you can't really protest. So that's kind of a hard, I still have a hard time, you know.
It is a difficult area.
Yeah.
Because it's a difficult choice.
Exactly, yeah.
Making, right?
Yeah.
And a lot
this,
of,
sorry for interrupting.
Yeah,
this nonsense that it's a woman's right to kill her own baby is complete stupidity. I mean, just because you might think it's your own right, but it takes two to make a baby. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, you can't just kill something inside of you.
It does take away the father's right, you know?
Exactly.
Here the government will say he's going to be holding legally to provide for that child, even if he doesn't want to be a part of it.
Yes.
But what about if the woman takes care of it and the woman and the guy wants the baby?
Yeah, right? True. That too.
But at the same time, you find, I guess statistically, in terms of, like, you say, you know, what about rapes and stuff like that? They account for, like, about less than 1%.
Yeah.
I think a lot of this stuff is just, I don't know, access to other information. I mean, you do have things like this, but sometimes they might come out to pretty strongly. Say, well, you're going to hell, and that's not going to be very persuasive.
Yeah, that's a horrible way.
That's a horrible way trying to persuade somebody, right?
Yeah. So I don't know why, like, a lot of Christians do that. They got to stop doing that because that's just pushing people away.
They're
going to be more non-threatening than threatening.
Right.
It's funny because I'm an atheist and I'm pro-life.
You're right.
And people are like, what? That makes no sense. But, I mean, there's a lot of atheists that are pro-life.
That makes sense.
Right.
Yeah. If you understand scientifically, I mean.
Right.
It's not really a religious issue, ultimately.
Yeah.
It's like you're killing somebody. You're killing a child.
Yeah, man. So I would say, everybody had a conversation. I really appreciate it. You're good, man. So I would say, because I was talking to the gentleman earlier, and he was talking about, well, we came to the issue of taxation. Taxation itself is not very pro-life.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. If you have to threaten the life of the other person to give them to surrender your property, you can't really say that's
taxation is completely theft.
Yeah.
But people really believe taxation is there to help you.
Right.
It's like government is actually taking money from you and giving it to themselves.
Yeah.
But they really think it's helping. No, it's not. You're paying them.
Right. It's like the old example people use. If I go to your house and mow your lawn, you know, and give you the check, you're like, well, hey, you benefited, right?
Yes.
So therefore you owe me money, right?
But they really don't, because people, I promise you, people stop paying taxes, government will fall apart.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that was Milton Friedman's greatest sin.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
The withholding tax.
Yes. Yes. It's crazy.
Yeah. Cool. So what do you do around here otherwise? Are you in school or?
No, I dropped out.
You dropped out?
No, man, that's complete indoctrination now. Right. Universities are completely indoctrinated.
Most of them are, yeah, especially the liberal ones. They got the biggest one here, American.
Yeah, very true. Business, entrepreneurism.
Nice.
I mean,
cool.
Freedom all day.
Yeah.
Everywhere.
Good. Are you into the crypto markets too?
Not really. I don't really like the crypto markets that much. I mean, it's a little bit freedom, but they still have, if you really look deep down specifically, they still have the same concept as central banking. I think.
Okay, yeah, you could look like maybe Ripple, you know, it is Bitcoin.
And this nonsense of scarcity is not true. I mean, you can make multiple Bitcoins.
Competing currencies?
Yes.
Or Bitcoin itself?
But Bitcoin itself, you can make multiple ones so that decreases the value. If you understand, you know, central banking, the more you print, the more your value decreases.
Technically, you could create more Bitcoin by creating an extra decimal place.
Okay.
That's true. But I don't know if that would necessarily depreciate this value. This maybe increases, maybe you're right about it, like in terms of its fiatness.
Yeah, fiatness. And it's online. I don't really trust that either. I like cash.
Well, most of your cash is online, though. Most of your money's on the internet.
Yeah, but right? I cash most of my money out.
You cash most of your money out?
Cash gives you so much more freedom. It's anonymous. You know, a lot of people understand, like, when the 2008 crash happened, Dodd-Frank bill, like what's happening in Cyprus and Greece, you know, all these central banks and governments are taking money out. Venezuela is a big example. You know, people are leaving their money in banks and they're taking their money out. People understand the next crash is going to be a bail-in. It's not going to be a bailout. So when the next crash happens, they're going to take your money out. You have to pay the government's bad financial decisions.
That's very true.
They don't understand that. That's happening already in Europe.
That did happen in Cyprus. The government passed a law, froze
and
everyone's bank account, stole 50% of the savings.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
I can see that happening here.
Yeah, definitely is going to happen here. But people are too naive.
But the thing is, there's no Bitcoin bank. You can't really steal, you know? It's as anonymous as you want.
But they said they turn off the internet, though, don't they? I mean, there's so many ways they could find a way.
It's just on a network. As long as somebody, it's online somewhere in the world, you know, it's accessible. You really can't.
I mean, if someone can educate me more and see more of the benefits than the flaws, then I might be able to be more.
So funny,
but I just like gold and silver. It's just so much.
Good, so you're a Peter Schiff fan then?
Huh?
You're a Peter Schiff fan?
Yes. Oh, definitely Peter Schiff. Ron Paul too. Yeah.
Good. Did you go to LibertyCon then? There was you ever heard of it?
I've heard of it, but I've never been there.
There was a big conference. Yeah, Peter Schiff there. Here in D.C. It was a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
A lot of gold bugs there. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I love gold. Gold and silver and cash. Yeah.
All right. So we were here earlier. He found me. You were saying, like, you've seen one of my videos before. Yeah.
Yeah. You're the first NCAP. I didn't even know what NCAP was, because I kind of got, like, a mixed feeling between minarchist or libertarianism. But if you really understand libertarianism, it's more in the philosophy of anarchy.
Right.
No ruler.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Minarchism is actually still government. Still slavery, in a sense.
Yeah, it's still socialism.
Exactly. I didn't understand it until Larkin Rose actually explained it to me.
Right.
Yeah.
So, I guess how long in the journey then have you been?
Whew, it took a while. I went from being super socialistic.
Yeah.
Very socialistic, because I was young. I didn't know anything.
Yeah.
And then I started working. And I saw how much the government really raped me financially.
Well, yeah, when you look at your paycheck.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
That doesn't say, you know, your employer. That's not employer tax.
Exactly. Yeah. And I realized how much businessmen actually help this country, or just in general.
Yeah.
Businessmen are the true providers. They actually help, you know, create value.
Yes.
And, you know, governments try to nag them and say they're the bad guys.
Right.
But they're really actually the good guys.
Yeah.
Usually.
Everything the market creates for the benefit of the people, the government likes to take that and, you know, perverse it into
exactly,
we want to see Amazon drone deliver pizzas. You see them drone bombing children overseas.
Exactly.
Right?
Democide is so insane. Government has killed so many of their own people, it's ridiculous.
Yes. But you know, only governments still have guns, right?
The government's never gonna use it against
never,
you.
Yeah,
ever.
Never, ever.
It's sad. It's kinda sickening, but I blame public schools. Public schools are the reason for this.
So do you engage your friends in some of these conversations too?
Yeah, I definitely engage my friends. I mean, a lot of them don't listen, but.
Right. Oh, you gotta nag them sometimes, right?
Yeah, yeah. I try to find a better discourse so they can understand, because everyone's an anarchist in their personal life.
Right.
No one's, you know, like, when we trade personally, so everyone's an anarchist. We don't, like, steal from you or.
Right.
That's government when they steal from you or they coerce you.
That's where the violation of consent
occurs,
right? Exactly,
but they don't understand that.
Yeah, when you ask somebody, it's like, you know, you advocate for consent, everyone will say yes,
consent,
right?
Yes.
So, like, right here in our advocation of one another, there's anarchy, right?
Yep.
The moment there's the advocation for us, you know, that's statism, that's government.
Yes.
So, you know, when people say, you know, well, anarchy is chaotic, well, you know, let's look at government. Government itself is chaotic.
Exactly.
Right?
Anarchy is not chaotic.
Right.
You know, we do anarchy every day in our lives. We just, government just labels it chaotic because they try to scare us.
Right, right. They excruciate the language.
Exactly. Right, it's like, right. Yeah, exactly. They manipulate it.
Right. They do a good job. This wrong freedom still, we'll call it taxes. Wrong freedom murder, we'll call it organized war.
Yeah.
It's not mass murder, it's collateral damage.
Yes. Right. Like instead of extortion, they call it taxation.
Right.
Or helping
right,
the
right.
public good. It's, they're very good at manipulating.
Yeah.
Super good. But they learn from, you know, other governments.
Right. It's like when you go to ABC in Virginia, they say, thank you for patronage. Like, I can't go anywhere else.
Yeah.
Right. They like to hold on to business words, like to kind of hide themselves from that. So
they're all collectivists.
Yeah.
If you look deep down inside, they're all collectivists.
Right.
Even a lot of companies that pretend to be capitalistic, but they are anti-free market, they're collectivists too. They profitize the profits when they're good, but they socialize the losses when they don't want to, you know, compete with everyone else.
Yeah, yeah.
They like to cheat the market.
I think there was I read an interesting case about like this dentistry that sent a threatening letter to like the parents. It's like, hey, your kid hasn't come for a checkup. And according to state laws, you know, there's a maltreatment of the child, and they can take your child away. And the state was, so like they're pretty much trying to use the state to push them into businesses, right? Trying to use the gun of the government to kind of force them in there. And like there was this outrage and everything like that. But you find that without the government, you really have to compete, right? You really have to innovate or go bankrupt.
That's true altruism. I mean, that's what freedom is.
Yeah.
Why would you not want to compete?
Right.
It helps everyone else.
Right.
It lowers prices. It makes better quality products, better quality services. But the problem is everyone's too, like, everyone's, like, not individual. Like, people are not really adults anymore.
Right.
We're still children in, like, adult bodies.
Here we are trying to get the opinions of children to legislate our lives away, right?
Yeah. Exactly.
I mean, it's hard for me to say, like, I can't really fuck because they're children, but at the same time, they're about 17, getting ready to be 18, you know, in high school.
Well, even 30-year-olds, I mean, there's the majority of people are children.
Yeah. And they'll use their children to accomplish their views, right?
Yeah. They get too emotional. They get very logical. They don't actually think it out. Like, if you really break it down, how our government is, it's still, you know, statism.
Yeah.
It's bad.
It is.
You know, it doesn't matter what flavor of statism you want, statism is still statism.
Right.
Evil is still evil. It doesn't
evil
matter
so
if,
evil.
If it's good or wrong.
Well, thank you so much for
definitely,
coming
man.
Out here, man.
Yeah,
it's great meeting you, Chris, right?
Yeah.
Nice.
Definitely, man.